jump back into the worship. We're going to dive into the Word of God for a moment. Before we do that, I just want to encourage you, if you're watching online, to share this stream with somebody you know. Let's spread the love of God. Let's spread a positive message. Let's reach people in the community. So I want to just encourage you to take a minute and send this to somebody. Today we're going to be reading out of Matthew chapter 6, starting at verse 14. And this is what the Bible says about forgiveness. This is what the Bible says about forgiveness. This isn't my opinion. This isn't what Marshall thinks. This is what the Bible says in Matthew chapter 6. It says, "For if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, your Father will not forgive you."
Amen.
It's so simple. It's so simple. He says it point blank. If we don't forgive others, if we don't forgive these people, yes, there's no reason we should forgive them. It doesn't make sense when all they've done is evil to us. Like, why would we forgive them? But it tells us right there, because then God forgives us. God will forgive us. And something, some notes I've written here is, all right, forgiving does not mean maintaining a close relationship. Forgiveness can be from a distance. Forgiveness can be love from a distance. Forgiving somebody doesn't mean you want to be fake to their face and be like, oh, yeah. That's not all forgiveness is. Forgiveness is just saying, I'm going to release that. I'm not going to hold that against you.
Yeah.
I release that. I'm not going to let it destroy me. Because if you don't forgive, what happens is that grows into bitterness. And then that bitterness just festers inside of you and destroys you from the inside out.
Come on. Freak.
Come on.
There's so many bitter Christians today in the church.
Come on. Come on.
There's so many bitter Christians in the church today. Forgiving isn't easy. They say it in the Bible like it's so simple. Yes, the idea of it is simple, but it's hard to forgive. If you can't forgive, if you're having trouble finding the strength to forgive, that's something you need to pray about.
Come on.
That's something that needs to be on your prayer list. Because if we don't forgive, I know I keep saying it over and over again because I want you to get it into your head that that's the only way Jesus will forgive you. So Jesus, we just want to enter into your presence, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Teach us to forgive, God. Guys, if you have bitterness in your heart, if you're holding on to something, if you're holding a grudge, I just want to encourage you in this minute, just surrender that to God. You don't have to carry that weight anymore. You don't have to carry that anger anymore. You don't have to carry that anymore. This is your time. Right now, this is your time. Just surrender it to God. God, I forgive the people that did me wrong. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord, I pray as we worship this morning, you would wash over this place, that you would wash over our minds and our hearts, that you would make us clean and new and whole and restored, that we would find a joy in forgiveness, Lord. That we would find a joy, that we would find a release, that we would feel freedom when we forgive. Do you know that forgiving gives you freedom?
Come on.
Do you know that? That forgiving somebody, because if you don't forgive them, they're holding, they have something on you now.
Come on.
That's that thing grabs a hold of you because you won't forgive them. But when you forgive them, that thing can't touch you. You're free from that.
Amen.
You're free from that.
Amen.
So, before we jump into the worship, let's just really prepare our hearts, guys. Let's just really prepare our hearts. I talk all the time about not leaving the same as we came in. That should be the goal every Sunday. There's not like we ever get to a point. It's like, we're finally good enough. I'm going to leave church the same as I came in because I'm good enough. We're never going to get to that point, guys. We're constantly going to be growing. There's constantly going to be a battle. The devil's constantly going to attack.
Come on.
Jesus, I pray you would lead and guide this church in how to forgive. I pray you would just put forgiveness in our hearts, Lord. I pray you would plant a seed in us this morning, God. Lord, I pray you would teach us to release the anger.
Yeah.
That we wouldn't hold grudges, Lord. All the bitterness, Lord, just wash it off of us, Lord. Wash the meeting place clean, Lord. Have your way in our hearts. We love you here, God. We love you here, God. If you love Jesus, let's just give him a shout of praise on the count of three. If you love Jesus and you're thankful that he got you here today, let's just give the Lord a shout of praise. 1, 2, 3. Thank you. Where we get to just enter into his presence and sing him praises.
Amen.
like sing these words. I've talked about it so many times about singing these words like we